sound we don't want to hear is the beautiful sound of your cell phones. So if you have a cell phone, please silence it, but keep it out to capture as many pictures and videos as you would like. Nothing about today's celebration or the people we are here to celebrate is basic. This day wasn't planned to strike you as such. And those of us who know and love this couple know that they wouldn't have it any other way. So get your cameras out and get ready to capture the love between Jess and Mark.
Oh my God.
She's got a good
movie. Yeah, thanks.
No problem.
Come on, come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Thank you.
Dearly beloveds, welcome. We are gathered here this evening to celebrate my first time as wedding officiant. And quite possibly my last. So when Jess and Mark asked me to be their wedding officiant yesterday morning, they told me I could do anything I wanted to do, which was then followed by 17,000 texts by Jess, telling me exactly what she wanted me not to do. But today is not about me. It's about the most important people here with us tonight. That's you, the guests. Each and every one of you is special to Mark and Jess, unless you're a plus one, and of course, just here for the great food and open bar, and that's okay too. So in preparing for today, I was able to sit down with Mark and Jess once, but that was no big deal since I've known them both for about 2 weeks. But okay, back to me, right? Here we go. We are really here to witness the union of Jess and Mark. Mark and Jess each remember times in their lives when they felt like the world was challenging them. And it's those very moments to which they attribute their successes, both professionally and personally. And what hard times taught this man and woman is that a happy life isn't about what you have, it's about who you have. Whether it's in business or in love, Mark and Jess are bound by their desire, or as their friends and family might say, obsession, to get to the bottom line. Jess doesn't care about napkin colors. Jess doesn't care about centerpieces. She doesn't even care about the name brand of her dress. What she cares about is whether or not you liked the food, if it fed your soul, and if you smell bad. Whatever the case may be, she'll want to find a natural solution that'll help you. Lucky for Jess, she found a groom who wants to help her do that. For example, they hate cliches. While they're both meticulous with details in their careers, they don't care much about cocktail napkins with witty wedding puns, and they don't care much about fitting into molds. What they do care about are the people in their lives who share their love, and their dog Velma. The people who have supported them on their journeys at this moment, and Velma the dog. The people who have lifted them when they were down and cheered for them when they've been up, and Velma the dog. And they realize that those people are in this room, as is Velma. So Mark and Jess didn't arrive to the altar today trying to fit into any wedding molds or to outdo their contemporaries. What they wanted was all of you, and they wanted to tell you the story of their love. Mark and Jess represent a new generation where more people are meeting through the airwaves than they are in the flesh. They met on Tinder, and although neither of them rely on the social constructs of religion, they revel in the sacred rituals and cultural traditions surrounding food. So it's no surprise that when Jess woke up the morning of their first date with a cold, she met Mark at the famous 4th Street Deli for a bowl of Jewish penicillin. They learned that they share the same favorite number of 17, so it was clear that Mark and Jess knew that they had found something special when the check came to the table in the amount of 1717 on the morning of 1-7. Now, the rules of numerology dictate that you're to take two digits, add them together to create one single digit. The fact that the numbers 1 and 7 amount to 8 is no coincidence. For the number 8 represents infinity, the symbol for which is tattooed to the bride and groom's ring fingers, meaning limitless or endless in space, extent or size, impossible to measure or calculate. From then on, Mark and Jess say that being together started to make them feel enveloped by love, comfort, and safety. I often speak to Mark and Jess about starting each morning off and ending each night with being consciously aware of each decision they make. Everyone here tonight, Mark and Jess, myself, we are all one decision away from changing the entire course of our lives. Mark and Jess, I want to remind you to understand yourselves and each other through compassion, or you will misunderstand. I want to remind you that in the bliss of love or the frustration of anger, you can change the course of action by simply deciding to. By deciding to communicate with each other through love first and never through fear, to always lead with compassion and always be present in what meaning and power to give to each event. A great, long-lasting relationship is always succeeded by two people that are in tune with their emotions and able to control them. When two people get together and they are both happy and juiced and high on life, everything is going to be smooth sailing. But the challenge is when one of the two, or even both individuals, may not be so high on life that day. And it will happen. Maybe one comes home from work and had a rough day, dealt with rough clients, coworkers, maybe even you're reevaluating the next stage of your life. Who knows? Well, what do you do when that happens? Some couples will yell and scream, and someone will inevitably say, "I am not your punching bag, don't take this out on me." But I encourage you both to hear these words again and again and again. Understand yourself and others through compassion, or you will misunderstand. My advice to you today, you do not have to believe or listen to, but I would like to offer it up to you anyway. Mark and Jess, here on October 7th, 2017, wear natural deodorant. If you would please take one piece of advice from me, wearing natural deodorant would be it. The long-term benefits of natural deodorant has been proven by the panel of Shark Tank. As the rest of my advice is no more reliable than my own meandering experience. Enjoy your youth. Well, actually, forget that. You will never be able to enjoy the power and beauty of your youth until they have faded. But trust me, in 20, even 10 years' time, you will look back at these pictures of your wedding today, and you will recall what you can't possibly grasp now, how much potential, opportunity, and possibility lay before you, and how fabulous you both really look. You see, you are not as out of shape as you imagine. Don't panic so much about the future. Well, you can panic, but know that panicking is effective as trying to create world peace by jumping rope. The real challenges in life most likely are going to be things that never cross your panic minds, things that sideswipe you at 4 p.m. on an idle Friday afternoon. Take nap. Do one thing every day that breaks you out of your comfort zone. Don't hold on to the past. Pulling from the filing cabinet is never a wise choice. Sing in the shower. Don't be careless with people in their hearts, and do not tolerate people being careless with yours. Meditate. Don't waste time trying to proofread all of your work, and don't try to prove your self-worth to people. Sometimes you'll be a star, and sometimes you'll be the supporting cast, but in the end, your self-worth is between you and yourself. Hold on to the compliments, dump the insults. If you succeed on doing this, teach people how. Be kind to your knees. They will be missed when they are gone. Get plenty of rest, floss, dance the funky chicken at your 50th wedding anniversary, and whatever you do, don't praise yourself too much and don't berate yourself either. Your choices are half chance, as are everyone else's.